Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel Alisha Maths Classes. So today I have taken the topic of class 12, chapter number 7, integrals. So today I will do exercise 7.4. But before that, you have to see the formulas which we have discussed in a previous video regarding the integration of some particular functions. So those who have not watched our previous video, please click on the I description. You can get the link over there. I have to watch the full video to understand the formulas of some particular functions, as those formulas we are going to use to solve the questions of these type of integrals. These are the questions of exercise 7.4. Without understanding that, you are not able to solve the integration of these type of questions. So basically in this exercise, we will do the integration of the integrals of the form 1 upon quadratic equation, 1 upon square root of quadratic equation, linear upon quadratic equation. You can see here that the numerator is a linear equation and this is a quadratic equation, and here we are having linear upon root quadratic equation. So in this video we will discuss some simple and shortcut tricks and which are very useful to solve the questions for board examinations also. So please watch my full video carefully so that you will understand the whole concept. So students, let's see the first question of exercise 7.4, that is integration of 3x square upon x raised to power 6 plus 1. So first of all, always you have to make the denominator in the form of x square plus a square or x square minus a square. That means you have to make the power square so that you can apply the formulas. Here I have written all the 6 formulas, all the 6 particular type of integrals, the derivations for which I have discussed in my previous video. So doing this, let's see now how to do. We can write down x raised to power 6x, x cube whole square and 1 whole square. Now let us substitute the value of x cube is equal to t. So taking derivatives on both sides, 3x square dx is equal to dt. So putting the values, 3x square dx is equal to dt, and the value of x cube is equal to t, so it will become t square plus 1 square. Now just you have to identify which type of formula we are going to use, or this form represent which formula. So you can see here by comparing that this is the formula of third type, where integration of dx upon x square plus a square is equal to 1 by a tan inverse x upon a. So using the formula, here a is 1, so 1 upon a tan inverse, what is the value of x in place of this? We are having t, so x upon a, that means tan inverse t upon 1 plus c. So 1 upon 1 we don't need to write down. So basically putting the value of t is equal to x cube plus c. So this is our answer. Students, please remember this thing. You have to write down dx and dt, because this is the common mistakes which students do in the examination, and even after doing the exam they don't know their mistakes. They just think about that they have done the question very correctly, but these are the minute things that you do incorrect in your question. First of all, you just forget the sign of the integration dx, and at last you forget the value, you forget to put the value of t. So please replace t, because this is a substitution done by you only. So put the value of t whatever you have done in this question. So students, next question is question number 2, integration of 1 upon 1 plus 4x square. So first of all, see here, we can write down it as 1 plus 2x whole square dx. Now just see here, if we will compare this form, this integral by the given formula, we are having only one variable x. Yahan pe kya hai? 2x. So what we have to do, let us take 2x is equal to t. That means 2dx is equal to dt. So from here I get dx is equal to 1 by 2 dt. Now substituting the value of 2x and dx in the question, what do I get? 1 by 2 is a constant, so we can take it outside. Dt upon square root of 1 plus 2x is equal to t, so it becomes t square. So that means it becomes the formula of the form dx upon under root of x square plus a square. this is the formula it resembles. So using the formula, what do we get? The answer is log x, but in place of x we are having t. So log t plus under root of x square, that means t square, plus a square, that means 1 square, is equal to 1 plus c. So finally, putting the value of t is equal to 2x, we get 2x plus under root of 2x whole square, that means 4x square, plus 1 plus c. So this is the answer, please note down. So students, next question is integration of 1 upon square root of 2 minus x whole square plus 1. First of all, see, we have to make the formula of this type. So for that, we will take 2 minus x is equal to t. Now differentiating both sides, the derivative of 2 is equal to 0 and it becomes minus dx is equal to dt. From here, I get dx is equal to minus dt. So substituting the value of dx and 2 minus x in the given integral, we get dx is equal to minus dt. So minus, we can take it outside. And in the denominator, it becomes, replacing 2 minus x with t, it becomes t square plus 1. And of course, everybody knows 1 can be written as 1 square. So again, this is the formula of the type this, dx upon under root of x square plus a square. So the formula is log x. X is, here we are having t, log x plus under root of x square plus a square plus c. So just don't forget to put the value of t here. T is, we are having 2 minus x. So 2 minus x plus under root of 2 minus x whole square plus 1 plus c. So we can just open this by using the formula a minus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab. So it becomes 4 plus x square minus 4x plus 1 plus c. So that is minus log 2 minus x plus square root of x square minus 4x, and 1 plus 4 is going to be 5 plus c. So this is the answer, please note down. So students, next question is question number 4, integration of 1 upon square root of 9 minus 25 x square. First of all, you have to write it in the form of a square plus b square or a square minus b square. So it can be written as square root of 3 square minus 5x whole square. Now by comparing with the formula, you can see here we are only having x in each equation. So we have to replace 5x by some other variable. So for that, we will take, let 5x is equal to t. You have to always take a single variable, because in all the formulas we are having only single variable, not with the coefficient. So taking the derivative, it becomes 5dx is equal to dt. So that means dx is equal to 1 by 5 of dt. So replacing the values in the given integral, it becomes 1 by 5 dt upon square root of 3 square minus, substituting the value of 5x is equal to t, becomes t square. Now just you have to identify which type of formula is this. This is the formula 1 upon square root of a square minus x square, which is this one, and the formula is sine inverse x upon a. So just replace x and a with the given values in our equation. Sine inverse x is here t and a is here 5 plus c. So this is the answer, sine inverse t plus 5 t upon 5 plus c. But at last you have to replace the value of t also, because t is here 5x, this is, sorry, 3, we are having 3. So sine inverse x upon a plus c, and the value of t is equal to 5x upon 3 plus c. So this is the answer, please note down. So students, next question number 5 is integration of 3x upon 1 plus 2 raised 2 into x raised to power 4. So again, you have to make in the form of a square plus root 2x square whole square. First of all, you have to form in the form of a square plus b square or a square minus b square. So we can see here that 2x raised to power 4 can be written as root 2x square whole square. When you will open it, you will again get this. Now you have to just replace root 2x square by t. this is a 3, so you can take it outside, better to take it outside, and we will take let root 2 x square is equal to t. So root 2 and the derivative of x square is 2x dx is equal to dt. So the value of x dx is 1 by 2 root t dt. So putting the values of x dx and root 2 x square in the given equation, what do we get? 1 by 2 root 2 is a constant, so better to take it outside, and the value of x dx becomes dt because we have taken 2 root 2, 1 by 2 root 2 outside, and it becomes 1 square plus, as we have taken root 2 x square is equal to t, so it becomes t square. I hope that you have generalized how to find out the integral of this type of question. In the first step, you have to make in the form of a square plus b square. And whatever the b square is, if it is not in the standard form, then you have to put this function is equal to t, so that it becomes in only in one variable without having any coefficient. Means always the coefficient is equal to coefficient of x square or t square is equal to 1. So now we can compare the formula. This is the formula of third type, which is equal to dx upon integration of dx upon x square plus a square. So the formula is 1 by a is here 1, tan inverse x is here t upon a is 1 plus c. A is constant and x is the variable with which we are taking the integration, with respect to which we are taking the integration. Here taking integration with respect to t, so tan inverse t upon 1. So the answer is 3 upon 2 root 2 into tan inverse, the value of t is equal to root 2 x square plus c. So this is the answer, please note down. So next, sixth question, that is integration of x square upon 1 minus x is to power 6. Again, I am telling you in the same question, in every question we have to follow the same procedure. We have to change the denominator in the form of a square plus b square or a square minus b square. Now we can take here x cube is equal to t. So the derivative of x cube with respect to x is 3x square dx is equal to dt. So the value of x square dx will become here 1 by 3 dt. Substituting the value of x square dx in the quotient, it becomes 1 by 3. So we can take it outside as a constant. Integration dt upon 1 square minus x cube is t. So it becomes t square. Now it is of the form a square 1 upon a square minus x square. So this is the formula of type 2, which is equal to 1 by 2 into a is here 1, log of a plus x, a is here 1 and x is here t. So a plus x becomes 1 plus t upon 1 minus t, that is a minus x, plus c. Now at last, don't forget to put the value of t, because this is the substitution made by you. So t is here x cube, so it becomes 1 by 6 log of 1 plus x cube upon 1 minus x cube plus c. Please note down. Students, moving on to question number 7, that is integration of x minus 1 upon square root of x square minus 1. So this is particularly of the form linear upon root quadratic, but we can do by separate method also. I will discuss that method in our next video. For doing the integration of the form linear upon quadratic, because we can do this question by some easy method also. So I am discussing here very easy method. You can do here splitting the terms. That means you have to take the both integration separately. It becomes x upon square root of x square minus 1 dx minus 1 upon square root of x square minus 1 dx. Now just looking into the function, in the first integral, what we can see there, that in the square root we are having the function and in the numerator we are having the derivative. So you have done in the previous exercise also, what we have to do, we have to take x square minus 1 is equal to t. But as we have discussed in all the videos, what I used to do, that whenever we are having the function in the square root, that then instead of putting t, we will take it as t square, so that it's easy to remove it from the square root. So although you can put it by, you can solve it by putting it is equal to t also, but to simplify in a very simple way, we have taken x square minus 1 equals to t square. Now differentiating the both sides with respect to x, so we get 2x dx equals to 2t dt. Now cancelling the 2 from both sides, what do we get? Dx x dx is equal to t dt. Now substituting the value of all these terms in the given integral, what do we get? X dx is equal to t dt, and square root of x square minus 1 is equal to t square. And in the next integral, it is actually the direct formula. You can see here, 1 can be written as 1 square. So it is of the form 1 upon root of x square minus a square, which signifies this formula. So just using the formula in the second integral, this integral, we can just apply the formula and we get our integration. So the answer is log x plus square root of x square minus a square. So 1 square is going to be 1 plus the constant of integration c. So root of t square will become t. It becomes t. And this thing you have to write down same. Now t will be cancelled by t. So the integration of 1 with respect to t is going to be t minus log of x plus square root of x square minus 1 plus c. So in the last, you have to replace the value of t. From this equation, we can take t is equal to square root of x square minus 1. So substituting the value of t is equal to x square minus 1 minus log x plus square root of x square minus 1 plus c. So this is our final answer. Please note down. I hope that you are understanding every question. So let's move on to the next question, that is question number 8. Integration of x square upon x square root of x raised to power 6 plus a raised to power 6. So first of all, you have to write down the denominator in the form of x square plus a square. So here you can see that x raised to power 6 can be written as x cube whole square, and a raised to power 6 can be written as a cube whole square. Fine. Now you can see here that the derivative of x cube is there in the numerator. So let us take x cube is equal to t. So differentiating both sides, we get 3x square dx is equal to dt, and from here we get x square dx is equal to 1 by 3 dt. So replacing the value of x square dx in the denominator, as 1 by 3 is a constant, so we can take it outside. So 1 by 3 integration of dt upon square root of the value of x cube is equal to t, so it becomes t square plus a cube whole square. Now it is changed into the form of dx upon square root of x square plus a square, which resembles our fifth formula, that is integration of dx upon square root of x square plus a square is equal to log of x, and in the place of x I am having t, log x plus under root of x square plus a square. So in place of a, I am having a cube. So we are using a cube whole square plus c. So the final answer is, just need to replace the value of t. From here we are having t is equal to x cube. So it becomes 1 by 3 log of x cube plus under root of, when you will put x cube, so x cube whole square will be changed into x raised to power 6 plus a raised to power 6 plus c. So please don't forget to put the value of t at the end, note down. So students, next question is question number 9. Integration of secant square x upon square root of 10 square x plus 4. So here we can see that this question is very easy, as we are having the function in the denominator and the derivative in the numerator. So what we are supposed to do, first of all write down it in the form of x square plus a square. So 10 square x can be written as 10x whole square plus 4 can be written as 2 whole square. Now let us take 10x is equal to t, because we can see here that the derivative of 10x is there in secant square x in the numerator. So without wasting the time, let us take derivative 10x dx, that means differentiating, we take secant square x dx is equal to dt. So substituting the value of secant square x dx is equal to dt in the numerator and using 10x is equal to t, so it becomes t square plus 2 square. Again, it resembles the formula fifth, which is dx upon integration of dx upon root of x square plus a square. So the answer is log of x. Here x is t, log t plus under root of x square plus a square, that means t square plus 2 square. Now at last you just replace the value of t. So here we have used t is equal to 10x. So replace t by 10x. We get log 10x plus under root of 10 square x plus 4 plus c. So this is our final answer. Please note down. In this video, we have learned about how to solve question number 1 to question number 9 of exercise 7.4. In our next video, we are going to discuss the further questions of this exercise. I hope that you understood all the questions of the exercise and how to apply the particular formula for a particular type of question. So if you love my video, please like, share and subscribe with your friends and family. Thank you so much for watching Alisha Maths Classes.